Hey guys, this is Comic You Know and Comic Frontline, and today I am doing a comic book review, a convergence review on Justice League International issue 1. And I do want to give a little bit of a disclaimer. I've never really liked Justice League International that much and never was able to get into their characters, but I wanted to pick up this issue because I want to like their characters. It's one of those things that I read a bit of Justice League International before the New 52, so when around Brightest Day, I think I read it. I think they had a tie-in series, if I remember correctly. It's been a while, but I read it, and I didn't really like it that much. I've never really been a big Blue Beetle fan, but I've always wanted to like Fire and Ice. I do like Red Tornado and Martian Manhunter, so I picked up the issue to see what it was all about. And let's see if I enjoyed it. First of all, I do want to say the cover is freaking awesome. I love the artwork for this. But let's see what's going on with the story. So with this issue, we get to see that the only person that has their powers is Red Tornado, because they made like this cop-out situation. It's like, oh, well, we made, you know, Red Tornado work, but everything else doesn't. They have like some computer chip. But at the same time, I'm glad they explained it, because I was like, oh, why is Red Tornado as his powers working, but not anyone else? I guess because he is a robot, but also in the Arsenal, in the Titans issue, Arsenal didn't have his arm because that didn't work. So I was like, oh, how are they going to explain this? And they do end up explaining it in the issue. And then the same thing, you know, Dome goes down, they get their powers, and they have to save their world. Other than that, I will say it's a bit of a generic issue. If you like Justice League International, I'm trying to see if there's anything else. Also, we get to see them fight some heavy hitters in the end here. So anyways, going back to it, if you like Justice League International and you like these characters, especially Blue Beetle, you get a lot for him. You even get a little reference of Booster Gold. But if you're not into these characters, this doesn't really bring anything new to the Convergence table. And I think I'm going to be saying that a lot in future weeks of Convergence. I didn't say that in week one because that was the first round. But as we get towards, you know, 2 months of Convergence titles, you want to see something different with each one. And some of them are going to be repetitive. And I think Justice League International kind of falls in those waters. Like, I did a Green Lantern Parallax review on Comic Frontline also. Go check it out. But that brought something different to the Convergence table. Justice League International, yeah, it has some interesting interactions. If you like these characters, they're there. They have some cool interaction between each other. But it's nothing new. It's just like, oh, don't fall down. Oh, we have our powers. Let's go fight somebody. There wasn't really any emotional beats. It just was kind of there. And that's the best way to put it. Is their artwork was average. You know, nothing, you know, too extravagant, but it wasn't bad either. So overall, it's just a very average book. If you've never read Justice League International in your life, this is not going to get you into the series. If you wanted to get into Justice League International, I don't think this is a series that's going to make this happen for you. But if you've been, you know, reading Justice League International for years, you like these characters, I say pick it up. But if you don't, this doesn't bring anything new to the table. So overall, not a bad issue, but just a very average issue. So Justice League International issue 1 for me gets 3 stars. And it's up to you of how big of a fan you are of this team and of these characters. But I hope you guys enjoyed. This is Comic You Know and Comic Frontline. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter. Don't forget to like my Facebook page. Also, in the description below, there's links for my comic book, Like Father, Like Daughter. And don't forget to like the Facebook page of Like Father, Like Daughter. I'll see you guys later. Bye.